Good evening and hogray the new. Hello, good evening and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews and me, Terry K. And I've got a Jock one here, Jock Lager. Brewdog 77 Lager. Now, what's it saying there? Juxtaposition Pilsner. Of course, try saying that with a mouthful of teeth. Try saying it without a mouthful of teeth. It's 4.7 ABV. Now, I'm always searching for a Brit lager. You know, a Brit lager to kind of get away from the Popsy McLager crap out there, you know. So I'm always searching for a good Brit lager to kind of, you know, fly the flag and do the honours. Because the only good lagers, it seems, is things like Pivovar, you got Brooklyn, they're all coming from all over the place. You know, Utenos, certain, you know, lagers from other places. I have not found a lager from this country that I've liked so far. I haven't tried loads. Because usually, the minute someone says, have a go at this lager, it's like, lager? Bottom feeding lowlifes. Right, let's crack the lid on that. Really pretty little lid with the Brewdog dog there. There's the little Brewdog dog. Little black lab, I believe he is in real life. Pretty little thing. Right, put the old BB away. Burp. Pardon me. That was a biggie. We'll be having this in my Umpty Dumpty. Oh, look! He's quite excited! Pardon me, this is going to be quite fizzy. Right, try to pour it as calm as I can, but I think this is going to be very fizzy. Now, I have not done my own work on this one, so you'll have to forgive me. I can't tell you a lot about it. I'll tell you that the Brewdog boys have got some really fun ideas. They've got great sense of humour and they've got some brilliant adverts in it. There's slight floral and fruity notes in there, but I don't know. Let's hope for the best. See, I'll go in this with a bit of a heavy heart. Every time I open a new British lager and that, I kind of go in with a bit of a heavy heart and that, and I'm like, oh, here we go. But anyway, let's try it. Have a little sniff. I'm getting cleaning fluids. Let's have a go. See, I don't have to cup it, I'll put my face in the bloody thing. Let's give that a swirl. It's a handy little hint for you. Swirl it, put your hand on top. A, if you're doing that in a beer festival or something like that, you ain't going to fight over the man next to you if you've had a few too many. But also, as it livens them aromas up, you'll trap them in there. I'm getting the kind of grassy aromas. There's a grassy hop in there of some sort. I ain't going to start trying to name these. Good Lord. It does smell almost like a Golding in there as well, but I don't know. There's not really that much apart from a little bit of a piney, kind of grassy hop in there somewhere. Let's have a little taste. Oh, that is nice. That's really nice. Oh, wow. I'm There's a very tanning kind of distant bitterness that comes in on a long finish. You know, it kind of comes in late in there and goes, yeah, you know. With me little Fuggles ring. Where's little Fuggles gone? There's little Fuggles. It's like, it's not Fuggles, but it's kind of like that. He's kind of hanging on there for dear life. There's him, he's got a long finish, but there's also fruity notes in there as well. Much better than the aromas off of it. Let's throw that about a bit. Mmm. Down here, you're getting the you're getting those kind of the those grapefruity sort of taste in that there, with a little bit of I'm trying to think of that. There's a fruit there. There's a little bit of apple skins in there. There's a little bit of grape, but there's definitely grapefruit in there. And maybe a bit of melon too. Oh, that's lovely. It's got a lovely bitter finish to it. A long-lasting, long-distance bitter finish that just screams out for another mouthful. The only unfortunate thing about it is that it's in a little 330 bottle. Now, listen, guys. All the Brits, every one of the Brits, 568 millilitres. You know what that magic number represents. Let's get imperial. Let's get, you know, I don't care if I have to pay a little bit more. Let's get imperial. Let's have a proper pint in there, yeah? Look at me. Right. Well, I'll tell you what, that is really beautiful. There is a kind of a bit of almond almost, without that marzipan sort of taste. A bit of sort of something going on. But it's a nice bitterness. I don't usually like bitterness. I really don't. I usually like, not bitter. I like the malty sort of really toffee malts. And this ain't really a toffee malty sort of beer. It's a very clean, fresh beer with a lovely bitter finish. That's a kind of that dry bitterness that's almost like that new beta hop. That kind of dry, almost a Chardonnay wine without the harshness bitterness. That is really, really nice. I don't know, maybe a North Down or something, but that is really nice. I like that. Guys, you've done an absolute... Look at my voice. Oh, I'm getting excited. Guys, that is absolutely beautiful. That really is lovely. I've got a lager here that I think is a kind of something to take on the world. That's really nice. Yeah, you've got the Brooklyn lagers that are kind of fruity and woo and all that, and that's cool. But you kind of can get that in a lot of other things. You can get that same sort of flavourings in things like Hop Bomb or something like that, like the Sadler's Hop Bomb and certain other things. You know, citrus and whatever. You know. So you can get those kind of like dancing flavours in other beers that ain't lagers. But this, I would say, is a proper true lager. But it is not a kind of... It's really good. Guys, that's brilliant. That is really brilliant. That's the work of genius. I think all that messing around and all that Coco the Clown stuff, I really think it's paid off, because these guys are now genius brewers. Brilliant stuff. Brewdog, fantastic. Beer goggles refuse.